station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, NASA's SpaceX Crew 2 arrived at the International Space Station. The crew, comprised of NASA astronaut Shane Kimbrough and Megan MacArthur, along with JAXA astronaut Aki Hoshide and ESA astronaut Thomas Pesquet, arrived in orbit to begin a six-month science mission on the space station. The Crew Dragon spacecraft, named Endeavour, docked autonomously to the forward port of the station's Harmony module on Saturday, April 24th. Supplies to support human research and STEM activities arrived alongside the crew. The astronauts were met with hugs and smiles from their Crew 1 and station teammates. On April 27th, NASA astronaut Shannon Walker handed over station command to Aki Hoshide during a traditional change of command ceremony. Hoshide, Japan's second station commander, will now lead Expedition 65 until October of this year.
Aki, I relinquish command. Congratulations.
And Shannon, I accept the command. Thank you.
The four SpaceX Crew 1 astronauts have a new splashdown date after mission managers waved off Wednesday's planned departure due to weather conditions at the landing site. Check NASA TV for the latest on continuous live coverage of the departure and splashdown off the coast of Florida from Michael Hopkins, Victor Glover, Shannon Walker, and Soichi Noguchi on board Crew Dragon Resilience. The new crew has already begun working on numerous science experiments aboard the orbiting laboratory, including the European Space Agency's GRIP and GRASP studies. The GRIP experiment studies the long-duration spaceflight effects on the abilities of human subjects to regulate grip force and upper limbs trajectories when manipulating objects during different kinds of movements, oscillatory movements, rapid discrete movements, and tapping gestures. Data from this experiment may be used to identify potential hazards for astronauts as they move between gravitational environments. These studies could also contribute to the design and control of intelligent haptic interfaces to be used in challenging environments such as deep space, planets and their moons, or asteroids. The Reaching and Grasping, or GRASP, investigation aims to better understand how the central nervous system integrates information from different sensations, such as sight or hearing, encoded in different reference frames in order to coordinate the hand with the visual environment. More specifically, the science team seeks to better understand if and how gravity acts as a reference frame from the control of reach to grasp. Living in space requires adaptation from more than just the astronaut's body. The absence of a traditional up or down requires the brain to adapt to the microgravity environment of spaceflight. This investigation provides further insight into how the body adapts to the microgravity environment. That's Space to Ground this week. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.